Welcome back, dear viewers, and you're still watching The Breakfast Show. And in this segment of our program, we'll talk about October War, as today we celebrate the 47th anniversary of October War victory. We'll try to shed light on the importance of the war and to what extent it's a chance to reinforce the sense of nationalism in the hearts and minds of new generations. And today we are joined by Dr. Maha Mahgoub. She is a human development expert. Good morning.
Good morning.
So, Dr. Maha, as today we are celebrating October War victory, what's your message to Egyptian youths in this day?
Yes, of course. Good morning. We are so proud of our victory because of the great victory. It was unexpected for all Egyptian people. Nowadays,
yes,
we are celebrating the 47th anniversary of this victory. Maybe some generations, young generations, they did not leave this era.
Yes.
But of course, other people left, and they were suffered before this war and after the war happened. Because, as I mentioned, that it was not expected, and it was really a surprise for the people, Egyptian people, and the whole world. And the success of the war was not only for Egypt but for the Arab region, because they helped Egypt to achieve its goal in achieving this war. So we are pleased today that we have won the war, although at that time maybe the Egyptian army were not equipped enough, such as nowadays.
Yes.
We are very powerful. So at this time, maybe our weapons, our army were not equipped, but the other Arab countries helped Egypt in order to win the war.
Yes.
By supplying them with weapons, soldiers.
Yes.
Cutting off petroleum.
Actually, the
and
whole
so
Arab world is celebrating this day, not only Egypt, because it's victory for the Arab nations.
Of course.
In general.
Yes, because at that time, before that, Israel just they injected a negative idea in Egypt and Arab world and the whole world that this is they cannot be defeated. So we have changed this mind, that we showed that we are very strong, especially these days. I'm so proud of our Egyptian army, because we are now the first army in the Arab region and the ninth all over the world. We are ranked as ninth.
Yes.
Although the struggles and the problems that we are facing in Libya, from Sudan and Sinai and so on. And so we are so proud, because we are setting the first stages all over the world.
Yes. So also, to what extent the strength of the Egyptian army is giving a sense of security to Egyptians in general?
Yes, of course. Of course, me as a citizen, so I feel secured. If I feel that we are well equipped. So nothing, any country, if they have any intention to do something wrong with Egypt, so we are quite sure that we are very strong country right now with our President Sisi and a good army, good equipment.
Yes.
And this, of course, inject a positive energy inside Egyptian people.
So, Dr. Maha, if we talk about the Egyptian woman and its role in the political life in general and its war, also during October War.
Yes, of course, Egyptian woman is playing an important role.
Yes.
If we monitor the history of Egyptian women, Hatshepsut and other, so they were ruling countries, and they are playing a very, very powerful role. And if we are going to talk about the Egyptian woman during the war of October 1973, if she inside the family, if she is a house woman, so she helped their family to boost and just to empower them and just to encourage them about how to support the Egyptian army. Outside the family, she gathered some donations for the army. She went to the Red Cross just to have nursing wounded soldiers, and she played an important role. More and above that, the Egyptian woman is injecting or planting good citizenship inside their children.
Yes.
So, yeah, if we have a good woman or a good mother, and she can develop the citizenship inside it, her children, that, of course, it will be reflecting the Egyptian people in the future.
Yes.
account.
Also, we were discussing also the role of Egyptian women in the upcoming parliament.
Yes.
And how the representatives, the quota of Egyptian women in the coming parliament.
Yeah, the last parliament, the quota of Egyptian women, she was occupying about 15%.
Yes.
But recently, the president allocated 25% of the parliament to Egyptian women, which is good for the women, just empowering and just giving her more empowerment to prove herself. Because if the Egyptian woman is the half of society, of Egyptian society, she is representing about 48% of the population, Egyptian population. And some of them are leaders, some of them are playing very important roles. So empowering women politically, this of course will be reflecting the overall situation in Egypt.
Hmm.
Because I think I'm sure about the mentality of Egyptian women. She's thinking strategically, planning and everything. She's a good decision maker. So maybe this party will be reflecting the whole, or have a good positive impact on the whole life, economic, social and political.
So, Dr. Ma, how can we reinforce the sense of nationalism in the new generation's hearts and minds, and what is the role of schools at this stage?
Yes, of course, we have two major parts. One of them is school and the other is family.
Yes.
So at the early beginning, that each family should inject citizenship inside their children and nationalism, and they have to show their children the importance of our country, our army, police, and so on, how to belong to our country, because nowadays maybe we have a lack of belonging to Egyptian.
Yes, because we have the influence of social media.
Yes,
we have,
of course,
influence of many media outlets. So how can we give them the truth about their country and their army?
Yes, I think schools are playing an important role. When we were young, the males just had sessions about how to develop this area to the young men or young youth. So they have to restructure the curricula of injecting nationalism inside the students, because we have to know more about the country, because how to belong to our country, because we have to dedicate our life, our future to our country. Unfortunately, some people, the calibers, or some of them, they are maybe exported to other countries, so they are using our mentalities and our youth and our people to develop other countries. So we'd like to retain and keep those youth and the population of Egyptian people by injecting belongingness to inside the youth. Therefore, they will be attached to the country and maybe it will be productive. And this, of course, will be reflecting the national growth and everything.
So in your opinion, what can youths learn from October War?
In Europe?
What can youths learn from October War?
Yes, of course. Nowadays, we are celebrating with the anniversary of October War. So a lot of youth just watching what happened, and some people, if they don't know what happened, maybe they can monitor a reading. And the now the generation are depending on the media, how to surfing internet and how to learn more about October War. But the family should just to provide some data or some positive thoughts about the October War. How did we achieve? It was very critical period for Egyptian people, because after the war of 67, so it was very critical. Most of Egyptian people were down at that time, but it really turned 360 degree the emotion of Egyptian people into positive energy because of our victory. So we have to give lessons learned to our youth. How did we pass this era? Or what about the taste of victory? So if we are going to implant inside our children belonging to our country, so maybe they are going to feel about what about the importance of being successful all the time, and how to belong to army and to our country.
So also, how can we benefit from these national events to enhance youth to complete the journey towards our country's development?
Of course, nowadays I feel that country is set a very important procedures to empower our youth. Maybe some of youth are occupying some places in the parliament, maybe they have a leadership program. Mm. So all of these programs are empowering our youth in order to be equipped for future positions, important positions. So if that youth, the youth conferences, so it's very important just holding such conferences, just to have simulation for youth, how to practice the political life, how to be productive, how to be a good decision maker, how to put them in a real and simulated situation, how to react into this situation. So we are empowering our youth and we are looking after those youth, because this of course will be reflecting their belonging and nationalism towards the country.
Also, one of the initiatives launched by the president was the PLO program, the Presidential Leadership Program, PLP rather.
Yes.
And this initiative also aims at involving youths and in decision making and making leaders in the future more professional.
Yes.
So how do you see these initiatives?
Yes, of course, it's very important, and I was monitoring the youth who were members in these initiatives. Some of those students who got the program, nowadays they are occupying some important roles or seats in the parliament, in some ministries and so on. So this the outcomes of this program is very positive in just engaging youth, which represents more than 60% of Egyptian population. So it gives them engagement towards the life, maybe political life, because we have to build a second line of leadership.
Yes.
Yes, and that should come from the youth, because they have advanced thinking and good mental thinking, out of the box, high energy. So it's good, and as well, the president just allocated 25% of the seats for youth.
Yes.
Yeah.
And in your opinion, what are the challenges that still face Egyptian youths, and the government needs to work on these challenges?
Actually, I feel that they have a positive and self-directed, so maybe they will never face any challenge.
Yes.
Because, of course, the successful people or successful youth do not depend on their family, their social status, and so on. They can build themselves by themselves.
Yes, also building the Egyptian character is one of the main targets of the government, and one of the important initiatives.
Yes, of course. Building the Egyptian personality and character is one of the country initiative, and how to develop from different points of view. And of course, but the role is not only depend on the country, but the role depend on the youth themselves and their families.
Yes.
How to have to be self-directed, how to overcome these challenges, how to have a self-assessment, and just to know what about their strengths and weaknesses, and how to have directions, what do they need, and what about their current capabilities, and then after to how to get benefit from the country or maybe the presidential's system, empowerment system. And on the other hand, the NGOs are playing an important role in order to enhance youth and giving them more opportunities for employment, raising awareness, empowerment, and so on.
So also, Dr. Maha, the October war victory was the armed forces achieved what was impossible at that time, and it was not just a victory, it was a lesson in militarism, and the world is still learning from it. So still we can see that the Egyptians can achieve the impossible.
Yes.
So how can we apply these nowadays?
Yes, as you said or mentioned, that we have lessons learned. That during the time of war, of October war, no one was expected that Egypt can defeat Israel.
Yes, it was the impossible at
yes,
that time.
Impossible at that time. And but of course, it was a hidden plan. And if we talk about strategies, it comes from the planning specialized in army. So army, they set the first place in setting plans. So we can have some lessons learned from the victory of October war, that how to have a strategic plan, how never is difficult, nothing is difficult.
Also the importance of Arab unity at that time.
Yes, of course. During the war of October, 6th of October, Iraqi, they helped Egypt with airplanes, 20 airplanes, Saudi Arabia just sent soldiers.
Between Egypt and Syria at that time.
And Syria, yes, and the war was halted at the same, dual wars in Golan and Egypt at the same time. So they were aligned together in order to protect Egypt and to just to defeat the other parties, our enemy.
So finally, I'd like to thank you, Dr. Maha Mahgoub, Human Resources Consultant. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
And by that, dear viewers, we come to the end of today's edition of The Breakfast Show. I'm Sheena Adel. Thank you for watching.